Hello dear viewers, I am Khan Bahadur, Assistant Professor of Statistics, and you are watching a video from my YouTube channel Statistics by Khan. Dear viewers, I hope all of you will be doing great. Dear viewers, this YouTube channel Statistics by Khan has been created for basic statistics with a view to help the beginner students of statistics, the researchers of all fields, and other learners of basic statistics. I have also a Facebook page and group with the same name, Statistics by Khan. You can visit them for steps related to basic statistics. Dear viewers, for better understanding of concepts in my video, I would recommend you to watch the full video. After watching the full video, I assure you, you will understand the concepts very clearly. In today's lecture, we compute the harmonic mean from discrete group data or from discrete frequency distribution. So let's start the lecture. Harmonic mean from discrete group data or harmonic mean from discrete frequency distribution. So for this purpose, we will take our discrete frequency distribution or our discrete group data. So this is the data set. Now the basic formula for the harmonic mean is, so this is the basic formula and this is the formula for individual data. But now over here, the data is not individual, rather it is a group data or a frequency distribution. So for this purpose, we will modify this formula a bit. Now if we look at over here, this is n. This n shows the total number of observations. So in the data set, 12 has been occurred once, 14 has been occurred 4 times, 16 has occurred 6 times, and similarly the rest of the values. As each value of f shows the corresponding repetition of the value of the variable, so if we add all the values of the f column, it will give us the total number of the observations in the entire data set. So for this purpose, the total number of observation, which is denoted over there by n, will equal to summation f. So if you total them all, it will give us the total number of observations, and summation f in this case is equal to 30. So now n is equal to summation f, which is equal to 30. It means that there are 30 observations, and it also gives another equation, that is n is equal to summation f. So now in this formula of harmonic mean, we can replace n by summation f. So therefore, harmonic mean is equal to summation f divided by, okay, now in the denominator of this formula is summation 1 over xi, but it was for individual data. Now the data is not an individual data set, rather it is a frequency distribution. So we will have to consider the frequencies as well. In order to get the sum of total 30 reciprocated observations, we will multiply the reciprocal of each of the observations by the corresponding frequency. So on the basis of this, the formula will become summation fi into 1 over xi. So this is the formula. So now this is the formula for harmonic mean from discrete group data or from discrete frequency distribution. So now this is the final formula. So from this formula, now we will guess the steps that are to be taken for the computation of harmonic mean. So as in the formula, in the numerator there is summation f, and we have already computed summation f. Thus harmonic mean will equal to, for summation f we will put 30. Now in the denominator there is summation fi into 1 over xi. So for this purpose, first of all we will find the reciprocals of the values of the variable. So we will construct a column with the title 1 over xi. So this will be 1 over xi. What does that mean? It means we will divide 1 by each value of the variable, that is 1 over 12, 1 over 14, 1 over 16, 1 over 18, 1 over 20, and 1 over 22. So now when we found the reciprocal of each value of the variable x, it gives these values. So now if we focus upon the formula, we need to multiply 1 over xi by fi. It means that now we will multiply the corresponding values of 1 over xi and fi. So the next column will become fi into 1 over xi. So if we multiply them, so we will get, so now this is the column which shows the multiplication of f and 1 over xi. But in the formula, we need the total of fi into 1 over summation xi. So for that purpose, we will add this column. So if we add this column, so notationally it will give us summation fi into 1 over xi. And if we add all these values, it will give us 1.706. So now in the formula over here, there is summation fi into 1 over xi. And when we computed summation fi 1 over xi, so it gave 1.706. So now we will put 1.706 over here. If we simplify this, so we will get harmonic mean is equal to 17.24. So this is the final answer of the harmonic mean. So this is the final answer of the harmonic mean. Or this is the harmonic mean of this data set. So this was a simple example from discrete group data or discrete frequency distribution. The purpose was to learn the steps that are to be taken for the computation of harmonic mean. So this formula was for individual case, and now this formula is for group data or frequency distribution. So if we focus upon this formula, so we need summation if. So for this, we will total this if column. Then in the denominator, we need fi into 1 over xi. So for this purpose, first of all, we will find 1 over xi. So we will take the reciprocal of this column as we have taken over here. After finding the reciprocal, we will multiply this reciprocal column by the corresponding frequency. So as we have done over here. So if we multiply the corresponding values of f and 1 over x, so we will get f into 1 over xi in another column. And finally, when we add this column, it will give us summation fi into 1 over xi, so which is the denominator of this formula. So this numerical quantity is for the denominator of the formulas. So over here in the denominator, we have put this value. After simplification, we got 17.24 is the answer of the harmonic mean. So this is the simple procedure of computation of harmonic mean from discrete group data or from discrete frequency distribution. Hope this will help you in the computation of harmonic mean from discrete group data or from our discrete frequency distribution. Thank you for watching the video.